So basically this is just an excuse really to get on the bike and combine two interests, motorcycling, which is an absolute joy, and photography, which is also an absolute joy. So well, you know, you got to enjoy your life, haven't you? Well, look at the state of the roads, look at it, and the fields, everything's so muddy. I'm on the Himalayan today. I just felt like I'd have a ride out. Got the photography equipment with me. I brought my Nikon D7500 DSLR camera, and I'm heading along a lane which is known as Fresden Lane. It's a very sort of countrified back road, as you can see, and I'm heading in the general direction of east. Well, I'm heading easterly, and I'm on the lookout for nice photographs which might have a hint of spring in them, anything which catches my eye really. Cottages, villages, anything that catches my eye, and I'm going to stop and take a picture of it. So I went out just a few days ago and I rode to a village known as East Hanny, and I went off the back roads and I found this lovely cottage, and I took some photographs of that, I thought they came out really, really well. So I thought, well, let's see what else I can see. So as you can tell, I'm riding my Himalayan, which is the ideal bike for these sort of like slow back lane bimbles when the roads aren't so nice. I can see a picture there. Oh, I might go back and get that. Maybe on the way back. So I think the first village we're going to come across is a village known as Coles Hill, which is a National Trust village. And so probably park the bike up there and take some photographs. I'll try and include, if I can, a photograph of the bike in the shot as well. I think that'd be quite nice. So yeah, a photographic motorcycle ride today. This is the little village of Coles Hill, actually across the border into Oxfordshire. I'm not sure where we can get to park the bike. Somewhere nice with a nice backdrop of the village would be nice. Maybe along here somewhere. That car there is occupying the ideal spot. That's a shame. Yeah, I found a nice picture. Let me show you this. This is what my friend Aunt gave me. The f-stop case. It fits the cameras, well, the camera, perfectly into the pannier. So really grateful for that, Aunt. Thanks for letting me have this f-stop case. And you can see, look, there's the Nikon D7500, which I'm using the 18-40mm, I think it's a kit lens, but I bought it separately, so I can see the shot I want. Let's get the camera ready. So it's a very simple composition. the bike on the left there, looking at the high street with the pub top of the hill, and the old shop and phone box on the right hand side. ISO 500. We could shut that ISO down a little bit, I reckon. 400 ISO, 1/200th of a second f/11. Take the shot. That's it. Simple as that. There's another interesting shot looking towards where the old cross used to be. Obviously it's lost its top, it's the base is still there, and there's an interesting cottage with interesting windows in the background. So let's take a snap of that. I'm using the levelling device on the camera to make sure everything's level, make sure I get the composition the way I want it. That'll do. Well, that's a few photographs taken in Coleshill. There's the old post office, what was, I think. Here's the pub. Radnor Arms. Yeah, a nice village. So basically this is just an excuse really to get on the bike and combine two interests: motorcycling, which is an absolute joy, and photography, which is also an absolute joy. So well, you know, you got to enjoy your life, haven't you? There's enough negative things going on in the world that try to get in the way and make life not so enjoyable, but the fact of the matter is that a lot of these things that are happening in the world are totally out of our control, nothing to do with the normal person. You know, we just have no control over what happens. I'm talking about what's happening over in eastern parts of Europe at the moment. You know, obviously it's on the minds of a lot of people at the moment. There's nothing we can do about it. So I just combine my two passions of motorcycling and photography and see what comes up. So I'm looking, as I'm riding along, I'm just keeping my eyes peeled for anything really which might draw my eye to make a nice picture, a nice image. So that could be a building, a thatched cottage for example, flowers, you know, early spring flowers, daffodils, crocuses, or it could be just a nice landscape. So anyway, we're just coming up now to an old hill fort. This is known as Barbary Clump. I'm not sure there'll be much to see there at the moment. It's known for its bluebells when the season's there, probably in a few months' time. Another couple of months for those. We might just pull into the car park and see what's going on. We're climbing up a steep hill at the moment, so you can hear the engine labouring a little bit. Let's have a look in the car park. Let's have a look over into Barbary and see if there's a picture to take. Well, I've already seen something that I like. I'll stop the bike and get off. Well, this is the image which drew my eye, and looking over to the embankment over there, the hill fort, and the sign in the foreground. I don't know if it's worth I reckon that looks alright. Just zoom in a little bit. Let's look at the histogram. Warm, lots of mid-tones, the sky looks very moody. So, yeah, I reckon that's a nice one. Focus a third of the way in F11, 1/400th of a second, 400 ISO. Take the shot. Let's just compose it a bit better first. It wouldn't be right to come here and not take a look at the hill fort itself. So I can really see the bluebells down here, look. They're the leaves of the bluebells rather. Let's have a look at the fort. Bit of a steep old climb. Oh yeah, look at that, look. That's gonna be a sea of blue in a couple of months. Not really much of a photograph at the moment though. Well, I'm just riding now through the small market town of Farringdon. I don't think I'll stop and take any photographs here, so I'm more interested in the sort of rural aspect of things at the moment. But Farringdon itself is quite a it's quite a picturesque town. It's got a nice market square. You can see the market square in front. I had my first job there in the Bell Hotel. I was the handyman there. That would have been back in 1979, 1980. So this is the road which goes up out of the town. Quite narrow, tall buildings either side. And at the top on the right hand side there's a folly, but I don't think you're going to get to see it. Anyway, I've been sidetracked yet again, and I saw the signpost of Pusey. So I thought, well, I haven't been here for a while. Let's have a look. Let's have a ride through Pusey and see if there's any photographs to take. They got cattle in the fields already. I think I'll have a little look up here. Actually, I won't. I'll turn round. God, I'm in the wrong gear. I can see a nice photograph over there, but I don't know if this camera's showing it. There's a little hand pump for water, but the thing is, it's outside someone's house, and I think you've got to be a bit respectful of that. You can't just get the camera out and snap away. It's got to be done a little bit discreet, I think. Nowhere much to stop there, really. Oh well, onwards, I suppose. Charney Bassett, that's where I wanted to go. Just seen the signpost for it. there we are. We're coming into Charney Bassett now. I've not been here for a long, long time. I don't know if there's much to see. Oh, this is Main Street. It says Main Street down here. There's a thatched cottage. That looks nice. Looks like there's a pub. Checkers Inn. Oh, I like this. Thatched cottage there. Lovely green. Lovely barn over there. Oh, I reckon we can do something here. Where to park though? Well, this is the green on Charney Bassett, but this is interesting because they've actually got a very old, what looks like the base of a stone cross, and they've obviously used it and put it on top of the memorial to the First World War there. And that's quite interesting, isn't it? Obviously the base bit is modern and the top bit is ancient. Just come a little bit further down the village in Charney Bassett and I saw this typical English scene. So just you've got a speed sign, 30 mile an hour, you've got a road sign, you've got some flowers, a bridal way sign, you've got a phone box and you've got a post box. I wonder if I could summarise all that in one photograph. Was difficult to get that shot of the phone box and the post box in Charney Bassett, so I had to sacrifice the picture of the post box. But I'm now going to ride through West Hanney on my way home. I don't think I'm going to stop. I'm just going to just ride through. It is a picturesque village, but I have to get home now. So I'll leave the camera rolling as we ride through the village. And I hope you've enjoyed this this little video, this little motorcycle photography outing. I'll probably do a few more of these as the year progresses, so we get a look at the area through the seasons. And of course, there'll be the motorcycle travel that we're doing as well, hopefully. So, once again, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Enjoy the village of East Hanney.